My great-great-grandfather moved to the Puget Sound area in 1890. That's when he started farming shellfish. I'm the fifth generation of my family to farm shellfish, and a lot has changed between 1890 and today. The Puget Sound is incredibly vibrant and very lush. It's a beautiful place, and the water quality where we harvest our shellfish has to be near pristine. Between 2007 and 2009, we started experiencing major oyster mortalities. Our partners at NOAA actually let us know that they thought it could be ocean acidification impacting our shellfish. After you spawn oysters, they start out as free-floating larvae. Building their shell is one of the first things they do in the first 48 hours of life. When the oyster larvae are in this corrosive water, they're unable to build their shell. A lot of other partners got involved. Scientists, academia, politicians started looking into this issue.
There are corrosive waters out there all the time. Depending on the combination of winds and currents and tides and so on, that can be drawn up to the coast. And that's one thing that a model like Live Ocean is very good at, is predicting the arrival of that deep offshore water right at the coast and its flow into the coastal estuaries.
EarthLab's Washington Ocean Acidification Center has been a really valuable partner in addressing ocean acidification. We've essentially come to the center with a problem, and they've come to us with solutions. We were able to get equipment in our hatchery that actually monitors the seawater chemistry, so we know what water we're pulling in. In addition to that, we are able to buffer the seawater, so we're changing the pH so that our shellfish can thrive, even if the water that we're pulling into the hatchery is more corrosive. And it's really made a huge difference for us. In the hatchery now, we don't experience mortalities due to ocean acidification. If we weren't addressing ocean acidification, we wouldn't be able to produce shellfish successfully. But we know this is going to have a greater impact on the ecosystem at large and really threatens the vitality that people associate with the Pacific Northwest. So I think EarthLab's mission is a really important one. It challenges how we've done things in the past to make sure that we come up with solutions and get the science that's needed right now to take responsibility for protecting this really special place.